In Kubla Cubed, the feature surface element can be used to define proposed elevations using outlines, contour lines, break lines, and points. It is the most powerful element, as any proposed terrain can be defined with the appropriate input data. You will notice that the user interface for the proposed feature surface is very similar to the existing feature surface. However, there are some small differences. Just like for the existing feature surface, we can edit from the rest of the project content showing, as here. Or we can pop out into a separate window by clicking here. However, I want to see the content behind, so I will pop it back in. Elevation features can be added manually by drawing directly on the screen using this button. If the CAD files are available, time can be saved by adding this directly from a file using this button. All surfaces need outlines to define the boundary. Now, there are different options to set the outline elevation. The first, extrapolate from features, takes the levels from the elevation features that are contained without the outline, such as contour lines and points. The next option, to use ground levels, snaps the elevation of the outline to the underlying ground levels. After that, you can choose to define varying levels, which allows you to set individual elevations at points along the outline. Finally, you can define a fixed level, which allows you to set a single level for the entire outline. The most common option to use is the extrapolate option, followed by the ground levels outlines. The other two are rarely used, but are required in some situations. Drawing an outline within an outline allows us to exclude internal areas from the surface. For example, we can remove this area from the middle by drawing an extra outline. Now I will delete this with the delete button. Once we have defined the surface boundary using outlines, we can then add any number of contour lines, break lines, and points to define the topography. Points are defined with a position and an elevation. They are the simplest elevation feature. Contour lines are defined in much the same way with a linear path and an elevation. In addition, you can choose to close a contour line. Break lines are also drawn with a linear path, but unlike contour lines, which are defined with a simple level, with break lines you can define the elevations at points along the line. These can be very useful for defining a hard edge in a surface, such as the embankment running along the side of a road. If you do not have a level at a point, you can leave the level blank, and the software will interpolate between the levels on either side. The break line will also take levels from any other lines that it crosses, such as the contour lines on this road. When you want to see how your defined surface will look, you can click Apply and it will be updated. This allows you to see the effect of changes you have made. When you have finished editing, click OK. This will apply the changes and close the feature surface editing controls. You can also click Cancel if you have made a mistake. With all Earthworks elements in Kubla Cubed, side slopes will be generated to join the surface to the existing terrain. The butter angle of the side slopes can be adjusted depending on your design requirements. The exception to this is if outlines have the Use Ground Levels option. In this case, no side slopes will be generated as the surface boundary will already meet the ground. As with other earthwork elements, the surface can be offset to Z to account for a construction thickness. So that was an overview of the proposed feature surface in Kubla Cubed. Thank you for watching.